My name is Megan Deehan. Thanks for joining me in the second video in our three-part series about environmental DNA. In this video, we will learn about technology developed at NOAA's Atlantic, Oceanographic, and Meteorological Laboratory that can be used for sampling environmental DNA.
Doing marine research out in the ocean or in the field can be a tough gig for scientists. Time constraints, bad weather and rough seas, or the need to go out at night can make research both challenging and expensive.
I would like to present to you the Sassy.
Yeah.
This instrument gets its name for its sassy personality, being able to fight off the elements of the ocean, tough against salt water, and its ability to take and preserve samples all on its own. Well, it does do all of those things, but SASSE actually stands for Subsurface Automated Sampler for Environmental DNA. I spoke to Nathan Formel, a researcher at NOAA's Atlantic, Oceanographic, and Meteorological Laboratory, to get the full story on the SASSE instrument.
Hi, my name's Nate Formel. I'm a researcher at NOAA's Atlantic Oceanographic and Meteorological Lab in Miami. Right now, we're in the Advanced Manufacturing and Design Lab at AOML. So this is a lab we've dedicated to creating tools to help our research and to do our research better. One of those designs is the SASSE. We use this to collect eDNA from the ocean. eDNA is environmental DNA. It's anything that came off of an animal, which could be its skin, it could be its boogers, it could be its mucus, it could be its scales. One of the big problems with doing environmental sampling is you don't know if you're going to be able to make it out into the field. If you need to go to the ocean and the weather kicks up that day, you can't actually go there. So what we wanted to do was create an automated sampler that would do all the sampling for us without us needing to be on site. So the SASSE is kind of like a sampling timer built into a sampling system. So we set the time that we want it to go off. It'll collect water using this pump. It'll push water through this filter that collects the environmental DNA in here. And then the secondary pump turns on and it pushes a preservative into the filter to make sure that that DNA is still in good condition when we collect it whenever the weather or our timing allows. If we put out one of these, we only get one sample. But if we put out 10 of them, we can have 10 samples at the same time, which is a really important concept in science, the concept of replication. You don't just measure something once, you measure it a bunch of times, and then you have a better idea of knowing if that's really what was out there. We made it open source and very cheap. The SASSE costs about $280 to build one of these. If you wanted to get an automated environmental DNA sampler elsewhere, you would have to pay over $100,000 for it. By using eDNA, we're actually able to see animals that we don't spot by eye, but we know they're in the environment, and that's really important for us to be able to create regulations so that people can act appropriately. If you don't know there are manatees in the area, you might not drive your boat slow. If you don't know sea turtles are in the area, you might not take measures to turn the lights off on your beach at night or to pick up extra trash to help protect an animal that you really love. For endangered species, eDNA is a great tool to make sure that we actually are successful in not just conserving, but hopefully rebuilding these populations of these big charismatic animals that we really want to see in the ocean, and they need our help to survive.